Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of 4x4 500 watt fiber laser channel. We are today doing a video comparing the difference between compressed air and oxygen. Spoilers, air won. But we're going to go ahead and show you the difference and the results of cutting. Now, the big thing with compressed air is it's massively cheaper. It behaves just like nitrogen. The cost difference, though, nitrogen is about $35 an hour to operate. If you're using bottles, that's assuming about one bottle of use per hour. Oxygen usually works out to lasting about 8 hours per bottle, so I think that's about $7 or $8 an hour, and compressed air is about 80 cents. So the cost of it is a lot better. It's more convenient simply because you don't have to change out bottles like you do with any of the compressed gases. I guess liquid would be a little different, but the compressor just stays running. We'll do another video separate of this one discussing just the compressor and the setup that you need to operate this, so don't just go to a big box store and buy one. You do need kind of a custom build on that. So today we're going to be doing three different thicknesses in both air and oxygen to show you guys the difference. The real advantage is in thin material, which is mostly what we do. We do probably about 6 to 8 tons of 22 gauge steel every year, which is about 0.7 millimeter for people that use metric. We also cut up to 14 gauge. Air works very good all the way up to 14 gauge. It is a little slower than oxygen. And we'll go ahead and show you guys the speed differences, and you guys can make up your mind whether air or oxygen will work better. This is the part that we're going to be cutting. As you can see, we have engravings on the front. This one is 2 millimeter, or about 0.0787 inches, which is the size of the slot, the hole, and the tab. And that continues down the part all the way to the 0.2 millimeter sample, which is 0.0078 inches. I did one additional tab as the machine surprised me by being able to cut a 0.2 millimeter wide tab without melting. I had to add an additional tab to ensure that the part would fail, as the point of this comparison is to show relative failure. The parts have all been compensated for the cut curve. Oxygen has a larger cut curve than air at 0.12 millimeter or 5/1000ths of an inch, and the air is 0.06 millimeter or 2.5/1000ths of an inch. Here we are engraving and cutting the holes. We have sped this section up. Originally it was a little over 3 minutes long. The difference from the longest to shortest is only about 9 seconds. I would not recommend doing large-scale engraving work on this cutting machine, as it is fairly slow. A galvo laser could do all the engraving here in significantly less time for less cost. For production engraving, that would probably be the recommended machine. However, for short runs of just a few parts, this works very well. This is also ideal for marking bend lines or weld locations on parts that will be getting additional forming stages, or for marking assembly numbers on parts to reduce confusion on more complicated projects. One thing that may surprise you is that the cut time is only 20% different on this part, despite the cut speed being nearly 4 times faster from the slowest to fastest. The reason is that the machine cannot accelerate fast enough on such a small part to actually reach full speed, which is something to keep in mind. A larger laser resonator may not result in significantly faster cuts on small intricate parts. It may be a better option to spend the money on an additional machine instead. So before we start looking at these, I want to mention these are the settings, the O2 that I've been using for almost 2 years, and the compressed air for several months. I did not change the settings to optimize cutting. I wanted to demonstrate making a part the first time and not dialing it in, making a whole pile of scrap metal. So some of these could be improved on, but I wanted to make it where I'm just using my generic program. So to start out with, we're going to look at the O2 22 gauge. 0.4 millimeter and smaller tabs are completely gone, and 1.2 millimeter is the last tab without burnt corners. And the holes here are not very round. The air, on the other hand, the 22 gauge, all but the 0.1 1 millimeter tab are all good, and even the 0.1 millimeter tab is halfway there. And to put that in perspective, that tab is only as thick as a sheet of paper. So very good quality on that, very impressed. Everything else is perfect. 18 gauge oxygen. The 2 millimeter tab was the only one that did not have burned corners. It was the only tab that was good, so anything bigger would be fine. Anything smaller is bad. 0.5 millimeter and smaller, the tabs are completely gone. And again, the holes are not very round. 18 gauge air, all but the 0.1 millimeter tab are good. Of course, 0.1 millimeter tab is gone, as they typically are. 0.5 millimeter and smaller are oxidized. However, they are all there. Holes good, except for the 1.9 millimeter, which failed to properly pierce. That could be fixed by adding a little bit of pierce time, but again, I only made one of each of these parts. I didn't try to dial them in. 16 gauge oxygen. The 2 millimeter tab is the only one that's good. Everything else has burned corners. 0.4 millimeter and smaller tabs are gone. Holes down to 1.5 millimeter are decent. However, the small, anything smaller than that are not very round and have a lot of slag on the back. 16 gauge air, all but the 0.1 millimeter tab are good, as just like all the other ones. Holes, for some reason on these, if you hold it up to a light, you can see like a crescent moon around it. It did cut, but for some reason where the lead-in contacts the side of the hole, it either welded back to itself or didn't quite cut. Now this can be a problem. Perhaps the dynamic cutting is a little off and it's not providing enough laser energy at zero speed, or it's providing too much and melting. So that would need to be played with to find out which one it is. However, the smallest holes I typically cut in 16 gauge are 3 millimeter and larger, and those perform just fine, which is why I never noticed this problem before. So now we're going to show you the settings that we used to make these parts. A few of the sizes do not have any pierce settings, otherwise they'll be shown in two different screens. You're going to have a pierce menu and you're going to have a cut menu. However, like I said, some of the thinner materials don't have any pierce settings because the laser goes through the material so quickly. Your results will vary depending on your steel supplier, exact steel thickness, as well as your specific machine. Larger machines, you will need to change the parameters in order to utilize this. However, it can make a great starting point and also a comparison if you are considering buying a 500 watt machine. If this video was helpful, hit the like button so other people can find it. And if you want to see more videos like this, hit subscribe. We have several new machines, including a bez cutter, CNC laser welder, that we will be reviewing and demonstrating once we have more experience working with them. We are also going to be touring a couple large laser cutting machines sold by Bez Cutter in the next few weeks, so expect those videos up as well. If you have questions, please ask them in the comment section. However, we are a manufacturing business, so we can't answer every question related to functions of the machines, especially if we don't use those features. Thanks for watching.